Today on Channel 4 News, we have an inspiring story about a young girl battling cancer. Now to Shelley with more information.
Hello everyone, here we are at Joe DiMaggio Children's Hospital in Miami. I am here with Jade, the mother of 13-year-old girl battling stage 3 pancreatic cancer.
Hi, I'm Shelley from Channel 4 News. Am I allowed to film in this hospital?
Yes.
What room is Daisy in?
226.
Thank you so much. Shelley from room 226. Today we're here with Daisy Miller's mom, Jane. How are you dealing with your daughter having stage 3 pancreatic cancer?
It's been very hard on our family, and it's just the hardest on Daisy because she's so young. But we've just been praying a lot, and it's in God's hands.
How has God played in all of this?
Well, faith has always been a huge part of our lives. And our family's relationship with God has become so much stronger through this. And by participating in the sacraments and praying every day, we have been able to overcome the pain that comes along with the suffering. And God has also stayed with us the whole time to make things much easier, and we think it might be time for her to receive anointing of the sick.
Hi, Daisy. I'm glad you could join us today.
Me too.
How old are you right now?
13.
How long have you had cancer for?
2 years.
What are some of your favorite hobbies?
I like to hunt with my mommy. Even though we're not done fighting, I want you to receive anointing of the sick. It doesn't mean you're dying, but it's time. Do you think you're ready?
Yes, call the priest.
Okay.
I have some questions. Can you come over? Okay, great. See you then.
So is my daughter eligible for the sacrament of anointing of the sick?
Yes, any baptized Catholic above the age of reason, which is 7 years old.
Does she receive the sacrament alone, or does she have to be in a group?
Either or is fine.
So what are the elements of the sacrament?
The prayer of faith, laying on of hands, and anointing with blessed oil.
Your stage 3 cancer has now progressed to stage 4. Hi, I'm just sitting in here because the doctor has to be in the room present.
That's all right. Okay.
Now please make the sign of the cross. Now I present you with the holy oil. Through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. May the Lord who frees you from sin, save you and raise you up. Amen.
Bushels of fun. Now the jingle hop has begun. Jingle bell, jingle bell.
What a heartwarming story. The good news is that Daisy's doing much better now. We actually just got a picture sent in of her, right?
Oh, good.
prancing in Jingle Bell Square.
That's all for today. Back to Jesse.
That's it for today, everyone. Tune in tomorrow at 8 a.m. for more.
1. I learned that anointing of the sick is an important sacrament that helps people cope with their hard times. It can really change a person's life and help them stay positive.
Through this project, I learned that anointing of the sick can be received by any person of age above 7 who are going through sickness in their life. It is a step towards healing.
Through this project, I learned that the anointing of the sick does not only bring physical wellness, but also brings spiritual wellness to people going through their everyday lives. Regardless of if they're near death or they're just going through a rough patch, they can be helped by the sacrament.
During this project, I learned many things. I learned how the anointing of the sick is presented in a church, a home, or a hospital. I also learned that you do not have to be terminally ill in order to receive the sacrament.